From this angle, I want to discuss some of the blood vessels that supply the head and the neck and also play a role in forming the cerebral arterial circle, or the circle of Willis. On this model, we can see the left common carotid artery ascending in the neck and then dividing into the internal carotid artery, which will pass through our carotid canal in the temporal bone, and we can see the external carotid artery, which passes external on the skull to provide many branches on the head and neck. One of the main branches we should be aware of is known as the facial artery. Here we can see the facial artery passing through the buccal region of the cheek. Now in this model it has been broken. This facial artery should come off of this point of the external carotid artery. Also, if we look a little bit further behind, inside the transverse foramen of cervical vertebra 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, but not C7, we can see the vertebral artery. The vertebral artery passing through the transverse foramen of those 6 cervical vertebra, and it will ultimately pass through the foramen magnum, where it will join to form the basilar artery, which takes part in the cerebral arterial circle. In this video, I want to discuss the blood vessels that make up what is known as the cerebral arterial circle, sometimes known as the circle of Willis. The circle of Willis is formed by blood vessels that come from the vertebral arteries and the internal carotid artery. On this model, we can see coming up through foramen magnum the vertebral arteries, and the vertebral arteries will join to form what is called the basilar artery, one artery which passes along the anterior surface of the pons. On this model, they do not show the posterior inferior cerebellar artery, but one which would have come off of the vertebral arteries. The lower of the arteries off of the basilar artery on this model is the anterior inferior cerebellar artery. Supplies the anterior inferior surface of the cerebellum. The next blood vessel we see off of this basilar artery is known as the superior cerebellar artery. Obviously, it will supply the superior surface of the cerebellum. Then this basilar artery branches to the right and left. A little harder to see the left here because the red has been chipped away. These are known as the posterior cerebral arteries. They will supply blood to the posterior portion of the cerebrum. I'm going to jump forward for a second. Coming through the carotid canal in the temporal bone, we can see the internal carotid artery here and here. That internal carotid artery will turn and head to the brain where it becomes the middle cerebral artery. So we've had the posterior cerebral artery and the middle cerebral artery, and those two are connected by a branch known as the posterior communicating artery. So we can see the posterior communicating artery here on the left and on the right, between the posterior cerebral artery and the middle cerebral artery. Also off of the middle cerebral artery, we will see the anterior cerebral arteries, which will supply the anterior portion of our cerebrum. And between those two anterior cerebral arteries, there's a short little branch called the anterior communicating artery. So these are the vessels that we pull together when we talk about the cerebral arterial circle of Willis. However, the actual circle is only right here in this small area. The cerebral arterial circle of Willis is comprised of the posterior cerebral arteries, the posterior communicating arteries, part of the middle cerebral arteries, the anterior cerebral arteries, and the anterior communicating artery to form a circle in this general region.